what's up, ladies? It's the Relationship Guru, Sid Pharrell. Now, I'm back again with another video just to give you, ladies. Now, before I get into this video, please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so that you're notified every single time I post. And if you are a woman that needs relationship advice, or you want to learn more about how to think like a man, or why men do the things they do, act the way they act, and think the way they think, then I encourage you to book a one-on-one session with me. Link is in the description below, and I can help you out with any questions, concerns, or anything that you have regarding your dating life or relationship currently in general, okay? All right, so we're going to jump right into the video. And this video is titled, Stop Trying to Rekindle Old Relationships, right? So a lot of times, you know, you as a woman, you might look back on maybe a certain ex or a few exes, and you might look back on them, and maybe you're single now, and maybe you don't really have a lot of, you know, success in your dating life right now. And now that's starting to make you think like, dang, you know, I had, you know, me and this one dude, my ex, you know, my last ex, we, you know, I kind of miss him, you know? And sometimes it's not that you miss him. Sometimes it's just, you know, right now you ain't got nothing going on right now, or nobody that you're really interested in, or nobody that's really showing you that attention, or, you know, giving you what you had before. So now you're trying to double back and spin the block, and you're thinking like, dang, you know, I want to go back to that old fling, that old man that I had before. And, you know, it's still not a good situation. Because a lot of times, you know, like I said, when you're in this state and maybe you're single and maybe you don't have nothing really going on right now in your dating life, it's easy to look back on the old relationships, the old situationships, and say, dang, you know, and it starts to make you want to go back to that old person that damaged you before. And, you know, even though you was like, damn, that person really hurt me, it was not good for me, it was still that experience that I have not had yet again, you know? So now you want to go back to that. But I'm here to tell you that sometimes it's not good to rekindle old relationships, because sometimes you just honestly just have to leave the past in the past, y'all. Y'all be so caught up in, oh, you know, I wanna, you know, it was good. You start remembering all the good times, but you don't remember what was the reason why y'all ended in the first place, you know? Because you have to leave the past in the past sometimes. Sometimes the past is behind you, and you gotta leave it where it's at, because when you try to rekindle old things, them old feelings, the old emotions, and that person that was not good for you, that you finally got over, now you're trying to put them back in your life, and now it's going to be nothing but destruction in your life, because it was a reason why it did not work out the first time. So why would you go back to something that didn't work out the first time, you know? And you may say, oh, people change, he changed, maybe he's different. No, if the compatibility part was not there already at the time, then 9 times out of 10, the compatibility is not going to be the same later on. And you have to remember, what was the reason why it ended in the first place? You know, you can't always look at the good, you know, people want to look at the good, you know, the women want to look at, oh, you know, I remember all the good times we had together, we did this, he took me here, he took me there, and you're missing those memories, but you're not remembering the bad memories. You're not remembering all the times where he disrespected you, he lied to you, he cheated on you, he put his hands on you, he just blatantly just disrespected you in your face. All these times. And you're not thinking about that part. You're thinking about the good part. You're thinking about all the times, all the trips y'all had together, all the times y'all was cuddled up having sex, all the good times y'all went on all these dates and y'all was cool and stuff like that. You thinking about that, but you're not thinking about when he put his hands on you. You're not thinking about when he lied to you, cheated on you. You know, all these things. You're not thinking about that, right? So you have to remember the reason why you left in the first place, the reason why it did not work out in the first place. And a lot of times, you know, you already know how the story ends. A lot of times it's just like you reading the same book over and over and over again, or you watching the same movie over and over and over again. Whenever you watch the same thing, look at the same thing over and over and over again, you already know how it's going to end, right? So if you already know how this is going to end, what's the point? You already know it's going to blow up in your face. You already know it's going to end up in flames. You already know that person is not a good person for you, because if they were a good person for you, they would be in your life this whole time, and they would have never left, and they would never fell off. But the fact that it fell off, and the fact that it did not work out, that should tell you something, that it's something there that's just not compatible long term. Maybe, you got to understand, sometimes people are only in your life for the moment, right? Sometimes people are only in your life for a season. Some people are not meant to be in your life for long term. Some people are meant to be in your life for just seasons. They go through seasons and reasons, right? It's a season and a reason why they was in your life for the time period that they was in your life. Sometimes it wasn't, oh, you know, they're supposed to be in your life long term. Not everybody's supposed to be in your life long term. It's not meant for everybody. You can't take everybody to the top with you. Not everybody's going to ride the same wave as you forever. You know, you outgrow people. You know, you just outgrow. You just mature. You know, you get older. You know, you start having different values and different, you know, things that you like, you know, and things that you will tolerate and won't tolerate. You grow as a person. And sometimes you outgrow people and you can't take everybody with you because sometimes that person will hold you back instead of holding you down. Sometimes that person will hold you back and will drain you and will use you. And you know, they're actually pulling you back, you know, instead of being there for you and riding the same wave as you. You know, some people are only meant to be in your life for a little bit of time, you know, just for the time there was whatever reason why God had them in your life for that time. That's what it was. And sometimes you just have to accept that and you have to move on. Sometimes you have to move on. You got to accept the fact that, it was what it was when it was what it was. And now I have to move on because I accept the fact that I had them in my life for that time. I thank God that, you know, I experienced that because you got to understand that everybody, you learn something about yourself from everybody. So regardless of if it was a bad situation or not, sometimes you learn more about yourself in that situation where you went through those experiences and now you learned about what you will tolerate, what you won't tolerate. You know, maybe that person taught you how to love yourself. Maybe that person showed you some things about yourself. And now maybe you know different red flags, how to deal with certain men, stuff like that, you know? So sometimes those experiences were what they were supposed to be. Just an experience for you to, you know, go through something. And now that builds your character, you know? And you have to accept that sometimes not everybody's meant to be in your life long term. It's okay. You know, if they're not meant to be in your life long term, it's okay. Let it go and move on. It's plenty of people in this world that will give you everything that you want, and you don't have to double back and go back trying to rekindle some old stuff that did not work out in the first place. You know, it's a reason why your rearview mirror is this big and your windshield is this big. You can't keep looking back behind you. You know, you can't always look back behind you. You got to see what's in front of you. You know, what's in front of you is what's going to be your future. What's behind you is your past. But your past, you're not the same person you was 5 minutes ago. You're not the same person you was yesterday. You're not the same person you was a year ago, 2 years ago, 5 years ago. You're not the same person. You're growing and elevating every single day, every single moment. So sometimes you gotta jump off the extra baggage. You know, sometimes it's not meant to come with you. You know, sometimes the extra luggage that you carry and you want to carry it so bad to your next flight, you can't carry it. You gotta leave it and buy some new clothes when you get out there. You know, so metaphorically speaking, what I'm saying is, okay, now you have to move on. The bottom line is you have to move on. Sometimes people are not in your life for a long term. You have to be okay with that. You have to be okay with leaving the past in the past. Leave it alone. Stop touching it. Every time you feel like you want to touch that man and you want to, oh, I miss him, man, slap your hand, smack your face, slap yourself out of it. Because you are going to do more damage trying to rekindle some old stuff that did not work out the first time. He didn't appreciate you before. He didn't love you before. He hurt you. He disrespected you. He cheated on you. He put his hands on you. He did all these things. Why would you want that back in your life? You just got over this man. You just now getting over this man. Why would you go back? You've been over him for a while, for a couple years now. Why would you go back? Why are you going backwards? We're not trying to go backwards in life. We're going forward in life. Whoever meant to be in your life will be in your life. If they're not meant to be in your life, then bye. And don't be trying to beg nobody to be in your life. Don't be trying to, you know, make nobody be in your life. If they want to be in your life, they would be. If it was meant to be in your life, they would be. And God would have it that way. And they would be in your life. But if they're not in your life, then it's a reason why. Because maybe you just outgrew them. Or maybe they're just not meant to go to the top with you. Maybe y'all going two different directions. Maybe at the time when y'all was talking, y'all was together, y'all was on the same wave and stuff like that. But sometimes people grow. People move on. People experience new things in life and they want to explore new things. And, you know, life is just just, you know, constantly changing. So sometimes that person that you had that strong bond with before is not meant to be in your future. And that's okay. You just gotta accept it and leave it alone. Don't touch it. Leave it alone. And go talk to some new people. You know, it's so many new men out there that you could talk to, but you blocking your blessings by keep doubling back to this old person that don't care nothing about you. You need to start looking for new people. Look for a new man, new experiences, a new potential partner. Somebody that actually care. Somebody that's new, somebody that's fresh. Sometimes you gotta clear your whole board and start over. You know, maybe your old ex flings or your old ex, you know, situationships that you keep trying to go back to. You sometimes you just need to clear the whole board and start all over. Get you a new squad. Get you a new man. Or if you multi-dating, get you new men, you know, or a new team, a new roster of men that you could talk to. A new roster of men that you could talk to. And maybe, you know, and that will keep you away from the past. Now you got new experiences. You should always want to be elevating in life. You cannot elevate in life by going in your past. Your past is going backwards. That's not elevating. Elevating is constantly going up, 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 going forward, right? You can't go forward. You can't elevate and go up if you're trying to go back and go down, right? You can't go back and go down if you're trying to elevate and go up and go forward. So you have to go up and go forward to be able to elevate in life in general. So if you're not doing that, then that's going to keep bringing you down. And you got to keep going. You got to keep moving. If people not meant to be in your life, leave it alone. It's too many people to trip over one person. You got to have an abundance mindset. You got to always think it's always somebody better. It's always somebody, you know, that's a better fit for me. It's always somebody that's going to treat me the way I'm supposed to be treated. And I don't have to deal with nobody in my past because I already know how it's going to end. I've seen this movie too many times to know how it's going to end. And it's not going to end right. So I'm going to just cut my losses. And whatever it was, hey, you know, it was good while it lasted. I appreciate you for showing me who I was at the time or being there for me at the time where you was. But now it's time for me to move on. That person was in your life for a season and a reason, and it's okay. You just have to move on. All right? So, ladies, I hope you enjoyed this video. And stop trying to rekindle old relationships, right? So, like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification, and I'm out of here. So, to the next video.